Hi, you have found the ultimate guide for installing your furnace. This is a guide that contractors will forbid you to have. Now, why would they want to do that? Well, money, of course. But for a second, let's not talk about money. Let's take a quick walk down memory lane. The furnace is the heart of your home. It provides warmth and comfort. Think back to all those Christmas mornings when your children and grandchildren were opening their presents. Do you remember their smiles? Remember how happy everyone was in the warmth and comfort of your home? Now, for one second, think about how that day would have worked out if your furnace was on the fritz. Yes, your memory would be very different. Kind of cold and uncomfortable. That wouldn't make for such a great day, would it? You know, as the head of the family, be it man or woman, we want our families to be safe. This is where the contractor will make his play on your emotions. What they're going to say to you is, you cannot put your own furnace in. You'll risk the family's safety. Think about your kids and your mom and your dad. I'm sure you've already heard it if you're looking to put in your own furnace, because I've heard it for a million times. So really, what is the truth? The truth. Why would a contractor want this book banned? Because they know you absolutely can install your own furnace, and you'll do just that with the help of this step-by-step guide. Not only will you install your own furnace, but you'll also keep from $1,000 to $5,000 in your pocket. And all this by following a simple 997 guide. I am here to help you understand the contractor's mentality. He's not your friend. If I was your contractor, I wouldn't be your friend either. Our relationship is about business, money. You're going to help me feed my family, and it's going to cost you. Yes, there are some good contractors out there, but you'll pay dearly for them. They're in high demand. They also get paid a handsome wage. But with this guide, you'll be able to keep the money right where it belongs, and that's in your pocket. Now, I want you to take a look on the screen right now. This is a page from my book, The Ultimate Furnace Installation Guide. As you can see from the video, ductwork comes in two pieces. They will need to be assembled. The assembly part is not difficult, but you'll have to make sure that when finished, the ductwork does not move around or shift or slide. That's where the guide comes in. It'll teach you things that took me over 20 years to learn as a contractor, and one of those is not to let the ductwork shift. Now, take a look on screen again, and here's another example. How to wire a thermostat. Sounds pretty simple, and most thermostats come with instructions. Really, how hard can it be? It's not if you have a good teacher and a proper guide. But take a look at this set of instructions that came with this thermostat. What in the world was the engineer thinking? It's difficult to read what's on their mind sometimes. Now, I could wire in this thermostat, but it takes a real pro to understand what the engineer was doing. Now, how could you, the homeowner, understand that set of instructions? There's no explanation. This was not written to help a homeowner install a simple device. And by the way, this is a very simple schematic. Now, take a look at this picture that came up on your screen. You feel a sense of relief? This is the set of instructions found with the Ultimate Furnace Installation Guide. It is very simple and easy to understand. Now, I'm not saying that this will cover all thermostats, but this is the standard in the industry at the moment, and this is a simplified view of it that should be easy for you to understand. I'm the author of this book, The Ultimate Furnace Installation Guide. Being an HVAC contractor for over 20 years, I've installed thousands of furnaces in my lifetime, and I just plain know how to install this equipment. I wrote the book on installing furnaces. Then I wrote this book on installing furnaces and handed it to my wife for editing. 4 weeks later and a whole lot of explaining, we finally had an edited book. Why did it take so long? Well, my wife found a flaw in my writing. I was writing as if everyone should just know what I'm saying. My wife made me explain every little detail, then draw step-by-step pictures until she understood how to install a furnace herself. Her final words were, "This is a good book. Even I could install a furnace." Now, let's take a look at what you're going to get with this book. Here's a table of contents that introduces the book to you. Number 1, Chapter 1, you get a tool list. Chapter 2, we're going to assess your home together. Chapter 3, we're going to assess your home's heating and cooling system, one of the most important chapters in the book. Chapter 4 is a material list for ductwork. Chapter 5 is a material list for electrical hookups. Chapter 6 is a material list for the gas line. And Chapter 7 is a miscellaneous material list. And that depends on whether you're going to put in an 80% efficient furnace or a 90% furnace. Finding local suppliers is chapter 8. And that's a tough one to work with, but we'll get you through that. That's easy. Chapter 9 is removing power and fuel supply. We don't want anyone to blow up now. Chapter 10 is securing the existing ductwork. We don't want ductwork to fall on someone's head. Chapter 11 is removing the old equipment. Chapter 12 is putting it all back together. And that is the most comprehensive chapter in the book. Chapter 13 is starting up your new equipment. And chapter 14 is a tutorial on putting ductwork together. Chapter 15, we have a disclaimer that helps you to understand that we're not responsible for your mistakes. And chapter 16 is an index. So now that we went through all that, what should you do? Well, remember the question we asked at the beginning of the video. Why would a contractor forbid you to have a set of instructions to install your own furnace? They would forbid you to have this 997 guide because they want your money in their pockets. But don't believe me. Look at this email that I clipped a few days ago from someone who saved thousands of dollars. Carl here bought my book and left the following comments in my email. So how do you get the forbidden book that contractors won't let you have? You do it by going to www.furnacebook.com. That's www.furnacebook.com, and you buy the 997 guide. Now when you get there, on the top right will be a tab that says download the book. And when you're finished with the book and installing your own furnace, please email us and let us know how much you saved and how easy it was and if we could improve the book for you. And let me be the first to congratulate you on outsmarting the contractors.